The person who came before me, I can't see him. Is he here? He's left outside, but I remember him coming 10 years back. Back then, cloud computing used to be called servers. So he had a what we call a dedicated server at that time with me, about 10 years back. That was before the word cloud computing became very significant. So I was very interested in what he was wearing and what he was talking about in terms of wearables and all that. Because the interesting thing about wearables is that I'd never seen some of those things. Huh? Some of those things were very interesting, no? Why would you want to be so obvious that somebody knows when you want to be intimate? I was really surprised that somebody wants that, but if there's a market for that, I want to know about it also. And before that was another person who came and talked about, Reddy talked about, I think, HR and interviews and how to do that. So I said it's a very bad place to be in, right? Bad place because somebody's talked to you about interviews which you care about. Somebody's talked to you about wearables, which are technologically interesting. And then I'm supposed to talk about cloud computing. So, interesting topic. And I was told to keep it a little lesser in terms of technology because a lot of you are new to cloud computing. So here's the topic that I was asked to speak on, which was about cloud computing. But today when I was coming, instead of cloud computing, I was doing cloud commuting. The commute had all clouds throughout. Huh? So in Bangalore, in Gurgaon, everywhere in India, there's only clouds, right? But those are the clouds of rain rather than the clouds of cloud computing. How many of you are cloud computing users? How many of you use cloud computing? Less than half the hands, right? Very good. How many of you know what is cloud computing? Using is one thing, knowing is another, right? Okay, very less. I like it. Then at least I can make an impact in the next 20 minutes or so. Good. So all of you are users of cloud computing in one way or the other, right? You all use Facebook? Okay, all hands up. All of you use Google, Gmail? Those are all cloud computing platforms. They give you software as a service, right? Gmail is a software that is for email that's being given as a service, right? Some of you use Facebook, which has a place to keep Instagram, which has a place to keep your photographs, videos, etc., right? So all of you are already cloud computing users. Cloud computing is new. In fact, like Ayappa was talking about, cloud computing is something of a word that has just come now in the past 5-6 years, but it existed even 10 years back. So why am I talking to you about this? I would like to give a bit of an introduction. I'm part of a company called Controllers Data Centers. We run the data centers in which the servers for the cloud are placed. So every time you shop from Amazon or you buy from Flipkart or you book your tickets on SpiceJet, all of that cloud computing is coming from one of these data centers. So my name is Prashant Jain, and I run the cloud computing and international operations for Controllers Data Centers, which is based out of Hyderabad. So just a little bit of intro on us. Some of you might recognize this building. When you go towards InOrbit, you must have seen this. This is our headquarters in India. We are Asia's largest tier 4 data center. So this is one of the largest data centers in India. This is more massive than your InOrbit mall. This is where a lot of those servers are stored that I talked to you about. This is our facility in Noida. A little bit of background on us. We are about 1,000 people strong. I was asked to talk about this because some of you are interested in career opportunities in cloud computing, which I'll talk to you about at the end in terms of what kind of careers you can explore and what you can do in this field. So cloud is currently one of the most money-making things, right? How do you know it's money-making? Because every software that you see, every advertisement that you see, what do they say? Cloud-based software, right? Everything that you use on your iPhone is either cloud-based or everything that you use nowadays is all based on the cloud, right? So cloud is one of the fastest growing fields. In fact, how you can estimate how big this market is or what cloud computing is by the fact that a couple of months back, I think about 6 or 8 months back, Flipkart had a sale. It was called a billion, big billion day, very right. And what did they claim that day? They said they didn't have enough computing resources to be able to meet the demand, right? Sometimes they have these, what do they call them, flash sales or whatever, right? Where they say in 5 minutes flat, everything disappears, right? in 10 minutes so-and-so phone goes away or whatever. So to take care of such massive demand, they said cloud computing resources are not enough, right? That's why you require these resources. In fact, the history of cloud computing is such that Amazon, which was one of the biggest bookstores at one time, created a company called Amazon Web Services, which was a pioneer in cloud computing, just because they needed that kind of massive resources for computing. Okay, so cloud computing, in a way, cannot succeed if today half the world that we live is on Uber, on... let me kind of get this slides properly. So a lot of these services that you use today, Uber, Ola, food services, and all of them are dependent on servers that are storing all this data, right? They remember all your details, they remember all your orders, they remember your order history, right? They have all the catalog that you can use. Now, these require massive resources, especially in countries like India. Why? Because countries like India, the demand is huge, okay? Nowhere in the world has an e-commerce retailer ever told saying that, you know, I can't match the demand. Nowhere in the world has ever a company been able to sell phones in a matter of 5 minutes. Okay, it happens only in India. And then people will pre-register and all that, right? So for that, massive amounts of servers are required. So cloud computing, as on this date, okay, is a platform that is ensuring that we call them as heavyweight dreams with featherweight businesses. Why? Because when I go nowadays to talk at startups and all that, there's only one thing that they tell me. They tell me I need somewhere where I can host my servers. I know only Amazon, or I only know Rackspace, or some other little service provider. And this is where I want to host my servers and all that. Now, even if the demand scales instantly, okay, cloud computing resources are able to meet that. Okay. So that's why cloud computing is such a big deal nowadays. A lot of you will be wondering about what cloud computing is, or at least the basics of it. So mostly cloud computing today refers to three kinds of things. One is infrastructure as a service, second is software as a service, and third is platform as a service. Now, infrastructure is simple to define, right? Previously, you would have a laptop, you would say, okay, you know what, my laptop has got so much i3 processor, i5 processor, or i7 processor. It's got 2 GB of RAM and about, you know, 1 TB of storage or whatever, right? You know what's the phone spec today? Phones are now sold saying 3 GB of RAM, correct? And 32 or 64 GB basic minimum storage available. And most of them have octa-core processors, right? So computing has moved at such a pace that computing power now, instead of being sold as servers, being sold as CPU, RAM, and storage. So instead of you buying a computer, the next thing will be you'll just buy computing resources. Instead of buying an entire computer, you just buy resources on that. And for corporates and companies, they obviously prefer to buy these resources on demand. So most of them are on pay as you use, which means instead of paying, this is a world of what? EMI, right? You all live on monthly installments only, right? So nobody wants to pay on a computer. They would rather pay on installments. So that is infrastructure as a service, where you sell by computing resources. Generally, infrastructure is sold in terms of operating systems. So here's a very interesting example I'll give you. About, I think, 8 or 9 months back, I was meeting the managing director of Microsoft India. And we were at the Taj. So they had taken us to the Taj to show us the Taj Mahal and talk to us about how the world was changing. At that time, Microsoft had come out with a campaign. I don't know if most of you remember it. It was called Cloud First, Mobile First World. Any of you remember it? So the way the managing director of Microsoft India was explaining it to me, he said, Prashant, you've been in cloud computing for the past 6-7 years, okay? But only now Microsoft has changed to cloud computing, right? How did you pay for Office before? You would buy a copy of Microsoft Office, you would get a CD, or you would get it installed with your computer, and it was called a perpetual license, right? It was a license that you paid for the entire lifetime, right? Now, what happened to that world? That world suddenly changed. What happened? Now they say, give us a monthly subscription. Correct? So he said, Shant, we used to go and buy and sell licenses for 3 years. Right? So they would come to a university like JNTU. They would say, okay, you know what? We'll give you these licenses to use and you'll pay us X amount of money upfront before they delivered it. Now what's the status of Microsoft today? You know how Office 365 gets paid? After the month is over, you pay them a monthly fee. Okay. 40% of Microsoft business used to come from compliance. You know what's compliance? Which essentially means you find out if you're counterfeit copies in your college or in your office or whatever. They come catch you and then they make you pay. Correct? Now in a cloud world, there is no counterfeits. You can't go to your friendly neighborhood. What is the bazaar here where they sell all those computers and all that? CTC. You can't go to your CTC and buy a license, right? Today, the software will switch off the moment your 1 month is over. So Microsoft had to find a way of getting paid postpaid. Previously, they were prepaid for the entire 3 years, right? They gave you a software, that's it. Today, what happened to them? They suddenly had to change their worldview to postpaid monthly, correct? So that's how infrastructure as a service works, okay? Same thing with, the advantages of this is that you can pay per usage, okay? You can pay by users. Nowadays, just to make sure that they are able to meet the demand and all, what they've done is they've said you can buy 5 licenses. It works on your tablets, it works on your mobile phone, it works on your computer, right? That's the kind of offers that they've been coming with so that they can beat the, exactly. The only way computing resources will be sold further on is only on a subscription model. Have you noticed all the startups that sell nowadays? They sell on a subscription model. They don't say, buy my breakfast for 1 day or whatever. I met somebody just outside. He had a company called Salad Delivery or something. And they deliver breakfast and salad in the evening. And he said, the only way we sell is 7 days or 1 month subscription. Okay. So everything is moving in the world towards a subscription model, not just your phones and all that. And instead of paying upfront, people are paying for resources, which means on-demand usage. So a lot of you use Gmail, right? Who has ever crossed the limit of Gmail? Who has ever crossed the limit of Gmail, which is the amount of storage that Gmail gives? Has any of you crossed? You're students, so most of you cannot cross that. So there is so much storage that these services are giving that even if you bought storage as a service, okay, you don't need to have any space on your hard drive to save that, right? All your photos are on Facebook already, right? Or are there any left? The junk ones must be left in your phone, right? So everybody's using them as storage, right? You can keep unlimited because they don't stop you from using as many resources as you want. SaaS, PaaS, and IaaS is how people are using it. Software as a service has been there for long. Like now you use Office 365 also instead of the operating system has moved to a model of subscription, which means you no longer use it on the basis of licenses. They charge you on the basis of amount of documents stored, and you can use it anywhere, right? That's the advantages of cloud computing. So let me kind of get you to, how many of you are technology guys who want to explore cloud computing careers? Wonderful. How many of you want to earn within 1 year $100,000 per year? How about I told you right now how to do that in 1 year? How many are interested? For this, I have to get claps now if I actually tell you what's the truth. So the hottest technology training that you can do right now, you know what it is? It's something called AWS certification. It does not require a background in technology. It does not require you to know any programming language. But if you do it, the demand is so high right now that an AWS certification, a typical average salary in the US for a guy with 1 year of experience on cloud computing is $100,000. When I was a student in the US, okay, I would have only dreamed of it after at least 10, 12 years. But that's the starting salary today. You know why it's so important? It sounds so silly, no? That why would something be so easy? All of you are surprised, no, that it's so easy. You know how much, you know what a startup gets paid nowadays if you go for a job and all that? What's the average salary that you get paid? What's the average starting salary nowadays for people like you who are just out of college? 10,000, 20,000. A Uber driver earns 50,000 today.
Do you know that?
There are Uber drivers who earn 70 to 80,000 per month. Why is that possible? Exactly. Because there is demand for that right now. Today, a couple of days back, when I was just traveling, I noticed that every time I took an Uber, the guy did not know what was Hyderabad. He does not know the navigation. Okay. He does not know how to travel. So I asked them, I said, how come all of you? They said, sir, I live in Chittur, Tirupati, Vijayawada, Guntur, wherever. And I know that there's no demand there, but there's a lot of demand for drivers and Ubers in Hyderabad. And I know I can earn 70,000-80,000 per month. I think I just shocked the people. I think they all want a career shift. No, please don't become drivers of this economy and technology. Don't do that. But the point is, technology can change things like that, okay? Unless you're prepared, you cannot survive, okay? Most of these drivers, they don't understand how the incentive structure works. Uber and all are very notorious, huh? They change their incentive structure every single day. Matlab, kal jo structure tha for the incentive is not there today, okay? So the guy has to be really smart. He has to know how to use a smartphone. He has to know how to click it on, off. Okay, are there any training schools for those guys? But do you realize that they're all able to use that? So Ayappa was talking about wearables and all that. Now, you know what I believe? I believe that the kids today, which means if you look at the kids in your family that are 2 or 3 years old, they're born with a thumb that knows how to slide. I don't know whether there's a wearable technology or not, but this is already built in. Bluetooth will come in the ear, I think, but I don't know how that will work out. But do you realize that they don't know? You give a small kid an iPad, he knows how to make the damn thing jump, slide, move and all that, right? That means consciousness, human consciousness already knows what to do, right? So whether you require wearables and intimacy apparel, I don't know. But I am sure that human beings naturally will learn. Uber has made more people technology aware. It has taught them how to use an interface, even though it's simple, but it still requires the application of a certain amount of brain, right? It has taught them how to understand incentive structure. Human beings are driven by only things. Two things, what? Greed and guilt, carrot and stick. Uber uses all of them. You want to learn human psychology, please learn there. You want to learn cloud computing, please come to me. So Uber uses cloud computing in such a way. Okay, all of them. So all of you by choice or by yourself, you are all using cloud computing users today. Technology has ensured that you're all users. So if an Uber user is using that, then you're students. So you should be using that massively. And this is going to be the next career that's available. This is going to be the hottest thing that is possible. All of you that invest in that, in careers in cloud computing, are going to reap the benefits massively. So my encouragement to you, because I think, what's your average age here? 25, 20, 22. So I'm almost 40, which is almost double the age, right? Of you guys. So when I first was in the college, there were things that I had to follow for whatever was the technology curve. Sometimes there's a hype to technology, right? There's a hype to technology. So everybody says, you know how to know what's the hype, what technology to learn? You know how to know that? Go to Amirpet, look at the boards, you'll know what's happening. You don't believe that? I have always believed that the way to learn what is the technology that's going to next come is not through predictions of scientists and all that. You go to Amirpet, you'll know, because those guys are adept at knowing what's the next technology that will come and how to train people in that, right? So cloud computing at this moment is the hottest thing that you can learn. I would encourage you to do that. Any questions you have on cloud computing or what kind of careers you have, I would love to answer those. Otherwise, I have only two words before I leave. One is G.R. Reddy came before me. He talked about careers and all that. He gave a lot of advice. I want to give you one piece of advice. And before sharing that piece of advice, I'll tell you a little joke. So there was this guy who used to pray to God. He used to pray to God, God, please make me win the lottery. God, all I want is money. So he prayed like that for 20 years. 20 years, what did he do? God, please make me win a lottery. One day, God got annoyed with him. He shouted, said, you fool, first go and buy a damn lottery. You buy a ticket, I'll make you win. So please attend interviews, because half of you don't attend interviews when the calls come. Half of you let go of opportunities before they happen. So I would very strongly encourage you, saying if life gives you a chance, please take it. Okay, thank you very much.
अरे हो गया.